Howdy, folks, and welcome back once more to Let's Play Dishonored 2. We're hunting, as we do. Corvo is not a happy man. And there are targets that I'm sure he will vent his ire upon. There's also a bunch of stuff in here that we should probably be poking around for, but... There's other things to be done first.
I guess Dr. Hypatia's not seeing.
Oh, man. I bet you that hurts. Knock, knock. Oh, that's dogs. Let's not. What? What? Oh, shit. Oh! So I suppose you guys will jump out at me? Yes, no, yes, yes. I mean, if I were you, I would. But at the same time, I have a gun. And, yeah. Seriously? Nice try, puppy. So I was carrying that guy, but it like just, weird. All right. So I'm carrying him, but it's not like showing his body on my shoulder. Strange. Alright, I assume that door is much the same as the other one. Ooh, there's... Damn rats that don't give me mana! Ah! I didn't know you were alive. Past tense, because now he's dead. Unsent letter to family. To Emma, Philip, and little Edgar. Things haven't changed much since my last assignment at Addermeyer, excepting I report to a different fellow now, and he's twice as strict. It's strange because there ain't really nothing for me to do. There's the doctor, but she just stays in and does her research. Maybe they need guards owing to the strange noises I hear at night. Not the usual creaks and groans a building makes. I feel any minute I might come around a corner and see something awful. But I don't want to worry you. I'll be back in a few days. Buy yourselves a nice fat chicken when you get this letter. Be good, Father. Oh, buddy. Yeah, see, like, now there's the body on my shirt. Whatever. Yeah, I don't think they're gonna be finding much of anything. We just killed a family man. Damn rats. Aww. Journal Corporal Valdez. It's been 6 months now since I came to Addermeyer on permanent assignment. Not sure it was a good idea anymore. First, I enjoyed the isolation because it allowed me to pretend I'd left my past behind me. But now I catch myself singing just to break the silence. I sniff and inspect every bite before eating. When I shower with water from Addermeyer's reservoirs, I don't feel clean. It's as if disease is in the very walls. So many sick people have come through here for years, and not only carrying germs, but suffering maladies of the mind. These kinds of things leave a mark on a place, even after the patients are cured or die off. I've never liked doctors. They have a particular smell, and look at you like you're just a pile of organs. I'm probably sick already, having breathed this cold, wet air for so long. It's hard to believe people used to come here to get well. Addermeyer feels like a tomb now. Maybe I'll go keep watch on the roof deck. Enjoy the sun while I can. Nice and dark. Seriously? 20,000 coins? I got so many kills under my belt, it's gotta be worth more than that. Sir Conan Kaiman. I want one. See, this is the kind of thing... I'm dwelling. This is the kind of thing... If I had a 3D printer, I'd have like 40 of these things and my wife would be bitching at me about it. This is why we can't have 3D printers. Also, they're expensive. One of these days. Alright, so we have a map. Alright, where am I? I assume this is the ground floor? So I guess I'm probably right here. Maybe. Maybe not. I do appreciate I can just... Oh no, there we go. We're right here. So, like, that's great. It's got, like, the you are here thing right here. But when you actually open the map, it doesn't. That's kind of dicky. But I do appreciate that you can just, like, look at it just like this. That's nice. Attention! Yeah, temporarily closed. Okay. Well, I'm not even going to tempt the elevator. What's up, buddy?
You ready?
Probably more so than you are.
Down. Megan can pick me up.
Oh, salute, eh?
You and me now.
Oh, you're a fancy lad. Oh. Do you see that? Cheeky motherfucker. Went to swing at me and then held his swing. Nice. I dig it. What? Oh, hey. Like, I really like they haven't done a lot to the melee combat, but they've made it, like I said, I think last time, like you can't just like spam swing and win anymore. And that's pretty great. Like I really like it. I'm not gonna go down there because there's probably like man-eating fish. This is, if I had to guess, is probably an alternate way to get in. Also, I'm out of bullets. Do you have any bullets? No. Come here. I have to use you for comedy purposes. Hi. Ha ha! Who needs bullets when you got corpses to throw at enemies? Jesus, Corvo's got a hell of a throw on him, too. Alright, you sit there for a minute. What do we got? Bullets! Crossbow bolts! A delicious apple. Where is he? There he is. Ha! I'm basically going to kill everyone. Like, if given the opportunity. I think this is where we came in? No, we came in on that rail. That's right. Oh. Oh. Oh, there's more than one. Oh my god. Get up there. Maybe it's a good thing. Beef stew. Yeah, I don't think it's gonna be beef stew. Fuck this game! Oh my god. Huh? What even was that? I just cut a dude's... What, did he have like a dead man's switch on him or something? What the fuck? Ugh! Ugh! I am despondent. That's some bullshit right there. Alright, I'm gonna grab this. I was robbed, ladies and gentlemen. Wholesale robbery.
I guess Dr. Hypatia's not seeing patients anymore.
Wow, dude. Alright. See, so I want this. Beyond the Black Spittle by... we missed this. By Ungar Pultami. A complete listing of symptoms due to the inhalation of airborne debris. Any of the following symptoms can be observed after sustained exposure to mining dust alone or in combination. Long list of bullshit. Should any of these be present as a prescription, I recommend a full change of air, followed by a month of leisure along the coast. Use suction to remove dust and debris from the nose and ears. Apply boiled onions and flax to the chest. These remedies should bring some relief, especially when used in conjunction. Okay. And hey, the Shindari Gift, a study by Amora Clipswitch. On the effects of the winds of the Karnakan landmass and resulting economic positions. Whale oil, oh no, we've already read this, I think. Liquid power! You're running short and shit's getting fucked.
Hey.
Oh no, something happened, guys.
Someone is asking for trouble over there.
Someone is, but not me. Oh yeah, this guy. Hey buddy, wake up. Or don't. Okay, so noted, if like you sneak up on somebody and you can't get into the like sneak attack position, if you just hit them once, it seems to kill them. I guess that's kind of a good thing. Fucking rats. Come back here, I'm not done with you. You supposed to give me mana, but you don't. Alright, lady, you need to get out of here. Before things get any worse than they already are. Goddamn. It was mentioned that these things, the blood flies, remind one of Cazadores. Not inaccurate. Oh, I didn't know we had a kill cam. That's fancy. All right, buddy, let's do this.
Time to collect this bounty.
Oh. Oh, motherfucker, you're gonna bring your freaking gun to a sword fight, huh? Well, all right. I guess if you want to go that route, sure, fine, whatever. Quick save.
Once that watchtower is down, Megan can pick me up.
Watchtower? Is that what killed me? Yeah, oh, there was a bunch of whale oil there. That'll do it. I bet you this dude's corpse probably bumped into it and cooked it off. Fair enough. I didn't even notice that. Does it still explode when it goes into the water? And it does. I hear him. Oh, there he is. Okay, there she is. All right, so we're good to leave whenever we want. Nothing. I've been neglecting. All right, we need her key. I've been neglecting to loot bodies, and I've noticed that the guys in, like, the gray shirts don't really tend to have anything. But it seemed like the red shirts, the dudes that typically carry guns, at least have some ammo on them, so I should. Alright, he did not. The elite guards typically have some goodies. More crossbow bolts. Man, I've got... How many of these things do I have? I only have 5. It feels like I've been picking up a lot of crossbow bolts. Apparently not. He's treading water, get it? Because his shoes. Okay, so we don't need her yet. We can't get in over there. It seems. Oh! Nice! Good to know! I was gonna say, that seems dangerous. I bet you that'd screw somebody's day up if I were to, say, knock a guard into it or whatever. Is this anything? Raw whalebone, nice. All right. Let's go ahead and take a quick look at the map. Yeah. Oh, and there's some healing here too, sure. Alright, so, we got a bunch of stuff above us. We have a rune over here. Like, I really should be paying more attention to these things. I'm kind of being a little bit of a jackass here, because, like, I'm gonna be screwing myself if I'm not careful. Is there stuff under us? No. Well, yes. What is this? One in the toilets! Damn it. A doorway to nowhere. More so just a door leaned up against the wall. Alright. That's like some old school first edition D&D bullshit right there. Oh, that was weird. Weird freaking creepy echo. But that's like some first edition bullshit right there where you'll like be trolling around in a dungeon. There'll be a door, and it's just like there's nothing on the other side of it. It's just a blank wall, because fuck you, that's why. Alright, so it's under this, which means I'm gonna have to go into the water, which I don't really honestly want to do, but we're going to. Maybe we don't need to go into the... Oh! Is it over here? It is, alright. So that's 2 bone charms, I think, that we just found, and a bunch of runes. So let's see what we got. Spirit water, drinking from a fountain restores mana, and health. Sure. That's like asking to have them combined into one. Alright, powers. How many runes? I only have 2 runes, which isn't really that enticing. Block to deflect projectiles. Eh. Yeah. Brutal fatalities kind of sounds nice. Attacking with a sword, parrying, and drop assassinations increase adrenaline. Once you've built it up, you can initiate a powerful sword attack that will kill an enemy in one blow. I'm gonna hold off for now. But that is a solid eventually right there, if I had to guess. I'm still just like super stoked. I'm still crazy stoked that we can double jump from like the beginning of the game. I don't know if we've read this, an auction held by... No, I don't think we have. An auction held by Kieran Jindosh, the grand inventor, offered for sale 2 of his latest contraptions. Marvelous clockwork soldiers, the likes of which have never been seen. The mechanical wonders sold after fierce bidding for an astonishingly high price. Never before has the wealthy class had been able to protect themselves and hold their holdings with such vigor and style. Prior to the auction, only the likes of Duke Luca Abel and more recently our new Empress could enjoy such protection. Having seen a demonstration arranged by the genius natural philosopher himself, I was witness to what his clockwork soldiers can do. Woe to any trespasser or villain who crosses their path. I dare say Kieran Jindosh has discovered a way to end crime altogether. I am certain that we are going to be getting chased around and I'm going to be screeching about these things at some point during this Let's Play. They're not just gonna show us that and not fuck with me, so... Yeah. Fucking... God, these dang ceilings. Like, the double jump... Like, there's a ceiling right there. Because screw you, that's... Like, why? Where am I gonna go? Come on. Alright, I don't think we've been over here. Some whalebone. I don't really... Ooh. Possible side entry. Rune. Well, now, what is here? Let me do this. And how is it locked? There we go. All right. So now that is super handy. Being able to just tick one that it'll just tell us where it is. All right, it's under here somewhere. Oh! Some Tivian ore. Well now, how in the heck? See, I don't think this goes down, like around here. No.
That's what I wanted.
What? It's probably people upstairs being jackasses. I'm certain that there are.
No.
And we'll be introducing ourselves to them shortly. Oh, they sound like they're bored, too. Well. All right. Let's,
Who's running around?
I'm not in the mood.
Who's Stop running around? The dude with the gun. That's who. Hi. That was a gunshot. 2 even. Anybody else? Ah! You suppress. Fuck, Corvo. No chill. No chill whatsoever. Keys! Curse you, game. Activate alarm bell. I wonder if I activate this, if they'll come out of there through that door. Likely not. Like, just the art in this game is really good. Soft rebels, windbreak. Freaking hookahs everywhere. They're getting their money's worth out of that model, let me tell you. Somebody doing some calligraphy here, it looks like. A blood amber cigar box. Ooh. I don't even want to know. You just doing some repairs here, buddy? Not anymore. I mean, I guess at least he died playing with his wood. It could have been worse. Oh, what's on the other side? Is there some unnamed horror in here? Do I have any incendiary bolts? I do. Just in case. Okay. What? Alright, I don't know why exactly this would have been walled off. There didn't really appear to be a whole heck of a lot in here. Unless maybe it was like a plague thing. Oh. That was a corrupt bone charm. Hidden behind a wall? False bookshelf, perhaps. Ooh, bad devs. What the hell was that? I don't even want to know. Because, like, yeah, if you look up, that is... Oh, I bet I know what that is. That is probably the game's, Oh, fuck. Occlusion culling corking up. What occlusion culling does is, like, it's to save your frame rate so that, like... For example, like, if I'm looking here, there's stuff on the other side of this wall, obviously, because there's a bone charm, so there's probably another room over there. But since the camera can't see it, the engine doesn't render it. And this is probably the engine thinking this bookcase is, like, larger than it actually is. So it's like, well, the player's camera shouldn't be able to see this, so we're not going to bother rendering it. And that's what's happening there. That's why we, like, if we look through from there, it's corked up, but, like, here it's fine. And if we look through this way, it's fine. Interesting. That, though, that... I don't know, that might just be lighting or maybe a seam in the geometry or something. But, yeah, that's like... That's the dark magic of game dev that is beyond me. That's just... All I know what it is. Okay, so how do we get to this bone charm? See, is there no book we can screw with? And again, I hear like that meaty, chunky eating noise, which is... Aw, man, I thought that was something, but it was just the fucking radio. Oh. Huh, apparently we can break the radios. Fancy. And doing so hurts us. I'm just waiting for this place to turn into like a hellscape of some sort. I know it's coming. It's gotta be. Like, this game's gotta go dark at some point. Well, darker, I guess. I don't know. Okay, so her office is all the way up top. There's the alarm. Oh, like, as much as I'm enjoying running roughshod over this place and murdering everybody, I'm actually quite enjoying just poking around. Like I said, the environments in this game are really nifty. Can I just... Oh, I was gonna say, can I just break...
What?
Seriously? Oh, there's probably guys out there, isn't there? Well, I mean... We have to introduce ourselves. I mean, there is...
I'll have a look around.
Who am I? That's a good question. I mean, really, when you think about it, who is anyone? Merry Christmas. One of them went over the wall. What are you guys looking at? Alright, there's a boat. Look at the sun. Burn a hole into your eye. Yeah, nice, dude floating down there. Oh, that's wonderful. Absolutely wonderful. Oh. Yeah, I don't know how I feel about them being able to, like, hear me through stone ceilings running around. I don't know. I wouldn't imagine Corvo to be that heavy. Whoop! Nope, I'm chill, don't worry. We cool. That is mildly terrifying, though. Alright, yeah, we got some nests. I see that. That's okay. That's okay, you guys. No, I'm not doing nothing, see? I'm chill. God damn it, Corvo. Get up there. There we go. Alright. No, I'm just, yeah. I'm just hanging around. Oh, seriously, fuck off! You damn bees! Alright, see, now I'm angry and you've inspired my vengeance and you get a grenade. There, that's what you get. What have we learned? Don't piss off the psychopathic assassin who's hunting for his daughter. Here, let's, come on, guys. I can't tell if they're hostile or not at this point. Yeah, I don't think there's enough of them. Alright. Well, we got our health back. Our elixir. Delicious, delicious elixir. That's... Can I, like... Is this the doctor, perhaps? Or is this just, like, some rando? They won't let me cut her down, which is actually kind of disappointing. Bathing salts. That's loot. Apparently. Lost entry in the matron's diary. Okay, that appears to be about it in here, though. So this is just, like, completely an aside, but for this. I've been dismissed. That's how they put it. Like, I just brought the tea and I could take my leave. And me, the fool, thinking I'm getting an afternoon off for a change, I says, grand, I'll see you early in the morning. Oh, my face turned a shade of crimson when they said I was never to return. Never. No explanation. I'm not even allowed to see the good doctor. I must have done something awful to deserve such ill treatment. But what? Didn't I always support Hypatia? Didn't I do all she asked? I was her other set of hands, her own words. I've been trying to recall what it was I could have done that was so wrong. I did leave that vial of medicine on the counter and it got spoiled, but that was over a month ago, and she didn't seem the least bit upset by it. Now I think she must have been ever so disappointed in me, perhaps was too sweet to say anything to my face about it. All that work left to do, too distraught to write anything more. So she's freaking... Like, that must have been some work, too! Like, based on her height, she would have lashed the rope up there, stacked this chair on the desk, and... thrown herself off.
As soon as you finished your current patrol.
Poor thing. Is that the way to go? Oh! Note to recuperation staff. The weather forecast promises a nice amount of sunlight tomorrow, so we encourage you to bring the patients who don't have an appointment for a lumiotherapy session out onto the terrace. Use wheelchairs if needed. We only have so many more tanning boxes, and considering how expensive they are, we won't be getting more anytime soon, nor will the broken ones be repaired. Sorry. So let's have our patients enjoy some real sunlight instead. Dr. Vaso. Okay... Huh. A rune or a bone charm nearby. I mean, they're everywhere. I can just not get to any of them. Because the goddamn keys!
Master key for the lab somewhere.
Oh my god. The elevator's a foot. Alright, there's somebody down there. There is! Where are you? Who's... Come on! Come on!
Shit, the alarm!
Where are you? Come on, guys! Well, you're not in there. Oh my god. Oh, hey. Got a key on you? No. Damn it. Oh. Oh! Basement! How is elevator? Oh, here we go. Haha! Oh, seriously? It won't actually let me go down. Oh, we have access to an elevator, guys. That means possible physics hijinks. Okay, no. Take me back up to 2. Wonder who what was. Someone I missed? Come here, buddy. We gotta do science. We gotta see how the game handles it. Oh, god damn it.
Stop!
I mean, if you guys wanna give me more things to work with, I'm not gonna complain, but.
Somebody's down.
Yeah.
Looking for a fight?
No! This is a sword fight. Oh, you fucker! That's what you get. Sword fight, not kicking. Alright. This is either gonna be glorious or very disappointing. That is quite a stack of bodies, if I do say so myself, but there can always be more. I gotta say that the physics in this are pretty good, like how this guy's corpse was there on the floor and I'd broken the wood and the wood was laying on his corpse. Most games would like half-ass it and just make the wood like fall through his body. But no, not so much. Like this is like, look at that. That's pretty good. What about you? You're not entirely in the door, oh my god, this is this is gonna be great if it like crashes. I am so impossibly disappointed right now, you guys. I do not even have words. All right, so I need to think, how am I gonna do this? Can I like, cause I need to get into the basement, right? We might be up too high, this might kill me. But if I had to, oh my god, Corvo, you fucker. Go in, there you go. If I had to guess, we can break through the floor down there. I can probably, I'm fucking, seriously, game. what is this? But no, it would make sense for there to be like the stupid ass got trapped in the elevator shaft, let's get him out button. Oh, that is so disappointing. There's totally stuff down there. I have to figure out how to get into the basement. But based on us being at like half an hour now, I think we're gonna have to wait until next time. So as per usual, folks, thank you for watching. I hope y'all had a good time and I will see you all then.